Hello and welcome to Equations of Circles. Please make sure you copy these notes down. Equations of Circles. Circles can either be centered at the origin or any other point on the coordinate plane. There are two different formulas. This is going to be the first one. When centered at the origin, the equation of a circle would be x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. And if you were asked to write the equation of a circle centered at the origin with a radius of 10, the first thing that you do is always write the equation of the circle first, x squared plus y squared equals r squared. And if you think about it, if r is equal to 10, then r squared would be 100. And the equation of the circle would in fact be x squared plus y squared equals 100. It's that straightforward and relatively simple, especially when it's centered at the origin. So let's take a look at the next one. If asked to write the equation of a circle centered at the origin with a radius of 15, first you're going to write the circle equation, x squared plus y squared equals r squared. And in the back of your mind, you're thinking that r equals 15, so r squared equals 225, and the equation of the circle would be x squared plus y squared equals 225. Okay, another example of that will be found on the next page. So sometimes you're asked to find the center and the radius of the circle when you're given the equation. So if you think about this for a second, the first thing we do is write the equation of the formula, x squared plus y squared equals r squared. So because these match, the center is going to be at 0, 0, and the radius is going to be equal to the square root of 49. So that would be the center is at 0, 0, and a radius of 7. The next one. If asked to find the center and the radius of this circle, again, we're going to write the equation of the formula first. X squared plus y squared equals r squared. So the center is going to be at 0, 0. And the radius is the square root of 23. Now that seems kind of weird, but that's exactly how you leave it. It would be somewhere in between 4 and 5, closer to 5, but somewhere in between 4 and 5. Okay, next page. On this one, this formula is a little bit different. You'll notice that we have x minus h squared and y minus k squared still equal to r squared, so it's the same as before. And this is when it's centered at h comma k. The interesting thing is we have a negative in the formula, so everything is going to appear to be backwards. So if it says, if asked to write the equation of a circle with the center at 5, 2, and a radius of 4, the first thing we do is we write the formula, x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. Now, in this case, we are going to put the 5 into the h spot. We're going to put the 2 into the k spot. And we're going to put the 4 into the r spot. So if you think about that for a second, it winds up to be x minus 5 quantity squared plus y minus 2 quantity squared is equal to 16. So again, you are given three different points. So the first one is going to be in your x, which is right here. The second one's going to be in your y, which is right here. And then the last one clearly is the radius, and it's going to wind up over here. So a little tricky, but that's how you have to do that one. The next equation. It says, if asked to write the equation of a circle centered at negative 3, 7 with a radius of 8, we always write the equation first. X minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. And I will remind you that this negative 3 is going to go in the h spot. This positive 7 is going to go in the k spot. And this 8 is going to go in the r spot. So take a moment and write that equation. And if you do it correctly, you'll have x minus a minus 3, which turns into x plus 3 quantity squared, plus y minus 7 squared equals 64. Okay, next. So now we're taking a look, and this is kind of backwards, if you will, but it wants us to find the center and the radius. So I'm going to write x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. And when you analyze this formula, it becomes pretty obvious that this 6 is going to be my h. And if you think about what number would make it to be positive 2 in that parentheses, it's going to wind up to be negative 2. And then the radius is going to be the square root of this 169, which is 13. So that's why it's the center of 6, negative 2, and a radius of 13. One of the things that you could always do is just take the opposite of whatever number you see here. It becomes positive 6. Whatever number you see here, it becomes, in this case, negative 2. And then don't forget to take the square root of 169 to give us the 13. So that's kind of nice because it always works that way. Now, having said that, let's take a look at the next one. Now remember, if you're trying to find the center, first you're going to write the formula x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. And the center is going to be the opposite of this positive 4, and the opposite of this negative 9, and the square root of this positive 1. So the opposite of positive 4 is negative 4, the opposite of negative 9 is positive 9, and the radius is going to be equal to the square root of 1, which is just 1. This is going to be a cute, tiny little circle, center at negative 4, 9, with a radius of 1. Last slide, and then we're done. So this next one is kind of interesting. It's almost a combination of the two formulas together, but I'm going to write it as x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. And once again, if we were to take a look at what number would have to be in here for h to work correctly, by the way, you've probably noticed that there is no number in there. Can you think of what the number might be? Well, guess what? The number is going to be 0. So 0 would work. If h was 0, then the x minus h would simplify to just be a plain x squared. Obviously, the opposite of negative 5 is now positive 5, and the square root of 36 is a plain 6. So in essence, this is kind of a combination of the two formulas together. When we have this formula here, clearly the x coordinate winds up to be 0, and when we have this coordinate here, the y coordinate winds up to be 5. And then we just take the square root of the radius, which gives us 6. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.